for our word of the day. And our word for today on the Friday, on this Friday of the second week of Advent, this Friday, December the 15th, our word for today is vindicated. Vindicated, our word for today. And here to talk about it is the one, the only Debbie Georgianni. I don't know, Debbie, if you were able to hear, but we did a story about an elephant in your honor.
You did. What did you say? I stepped away to get a cup of coffee, and I heard my name vaguely in the distance. So I'm sure it was something nice about elephants.
Oh,
right?
Yeah. It was the best way to eat a 10,000-pound elephant.
Yeah.
And what are Debbie's favorite recipes for doing this?
Grilling tips. Horrible. Yeah, they're all there.
Why? You guys are triggering me, okay? Stop it.
No, the oldest elephant, the first elephant at the St. Louis Zoo is moving to Columbus.
Really?
Yeah, they're going to take the elephant Raja and introduce him to the ladies there at the Columbus Zoo and Aquarium in hopes of, and they're saying that they want him to be to mentor the offspring.
Yeah. And then his final destination is a barbecue place like three blocks away. But we won't talk about that. They didn't include
the right
that.
Well,
yeah.
No joke. Do you guys remember the elephant that it was a great artist where they sold all those art pieces?
Oh, that's right.
Oh,
yeah.
They're very talented animals and God's creatures. And I just think it's kind of cruel when pledge drive hosts like try to make, they try to say, well, how do you eat an elephant one bite at a time? I mean, why pick on elephants? I'm just saying.
Yeah. I agree with you.
I resemble that remark.
No, it was pretty funny. It was pretty funny. And then we had a priest's mom send in a recipe on elephant stew or something. Really hilarious.
But insult to injury.
Yeah, I was kind of praying that the elephant would, because I said to the co-host, his name is Dominic, and I said, Dominic, I said, what if the elephant came up to you and was sitting next to you on a park bench? He said he would probably crush me. I said, yeah, I hope. I kind of hope.
Well, Raja seems to have a perfect life plan for him in Columbus, so I think he'll be pretty happy.
I root for God's creatures. Okay, I'm into birds lately. If anybody's on Facebook and you're friends with me on Facebook, in fact, a lot of Annunciation Radio listeners are friends with me on Facebook, and you guys will see that these birds are amazing. These peacocks, have you ever noticed that when the peacock, fans out, they're all little eyes? Have you ever noticed that?
Oh, yeah, that's right, yeah.
Yeah.
Isn't that amazing, God's sense of humor?
Now, this area, Debbie, Toledo is people from all over the world travel to Toledo for bird watching at a particular time of the year. Yeah, big business here in Toledo.
Wow, I didn't know that. It's fascinating. Mm-hmm. So I'm totally into birds. Everybody's like, okay, Debbie, can you get on to another subject? Because I keep posting all these,
I'm fascinated.
These bird pictures. But anyway, so back to the word of the day. That was a great reflection, Dave. Real simply, when I turned 50 and then I got sick again with a second bout of cancer, after that, I just started to go back to a lot of the saints. And I said, I think it's just getting too complicated, I mean, and no offense to any theologians, high theologians and biblical scholars and philosophers and everybody that's really heady and, knows how to dissect everything with 9-syllable words. I have the utmost respect for you. I think you're amazing. I think your brain's going to be donated to science to find out what's in your brain. Okay. But it's just not the way I roll in life. And I realized I had to go back to the saints, and I went back to Mother Teresa. See, I'm getting, I can feel the Holy Spirit as I'm saying this. This is so interesting. I went back to Mother Teresa, John Paul II, Blessed Carlo Acutis, St. Faustina, St. Therese of Lisieux, St. Teresa of Avila, however you want to pronounce it, and then contemporary holy woman of God, Mother Angelica. And I said, we're just making this too complicated. It's about faithfulness. It's about trust. It's about dedication. It's about loyalty. It's about knowing the bigger picture and trusting completely and surrendering and saying, okay, Lord, I'm putting all my eggs in this basket and I'm going with you. I believe in the end of the story. I want to be in union with you. I want to get there. I want to stay connected here on this side of the veil. And that's what that's how I conduct my life now. And I will tell you, my life's been really fun.
You know, and it's a good point, Debbie. We can make this as complicated as we want. And I don't think it's wrong to make it complicated as long as we keep the main thing the main thing. And exactly. That is our relationship with the Lord. And yep. Everything is about eternity.
Got to keep it perspective.
In perspective, yeah. And you nailed it. And I do like the characters you picked, Sam Elliott and everybody. I think that was great. You guys go for it. Try to get them. Book them.
I still think Gilligan from Gilligan's Island. Right.
And Debbie's basically saying Danny DeVito for me. That's everybody. Everybody thinks it. It's good.
God bless you guys. I love you too. Have a great weekend.
God bless.
Thanks, Dave, or should I say Brad Pitt?
Yeah. Have a great weekend.